Hello, in this video we'll talk about some radio transmitters for your Arduino projects or even Raspberry or other SBCs. So this one here is the RF22. It works at the same frequency as the Wi-Fi, so it's 2.4 GHz, and it uses an SPI protocol. SPI stands for Serial Peripheral Interface, and I will zoom a bit. If you can read here, SAK, M1, M0, etc., these are the pins of the SPI, so it needs at least 6 pins plus 2 for the power here. And this has a range like of 90-100 meters. You see that it integrates this antenna that we can deattach with this connector. So we could even put some cable to put the antenna far away from the circuit or in the top of the roof if we want to increase the range from our home. But this is not the sensor or the radio transceiver I will talk about this video. The subject of this video are these two. I forgot to say, these transmit and receive, so if you have two, you can have a bidirectional communication. Then we have this, which is a much cheaper technology. The sensor is just this and this. So this is a transceiver, this is a receiver. And this has a very limited range. It works at the frequency of 433 megahertz. I have a video using this like more than 1 year ago in this channel. You can check, I make some communication between these two using a Raspberry Pi. But the range is very low, like 10 meter or even less, like 4 meter. So I decided to add some antennas to increase the range. So I added a monopole antenna. I will focus a bit. To the transceiver, I added this antenna here, monopole antenna, and a dipole to the receiver. So how does it work? Simply, in the point where it says antenna, you solder this wire, and I will explain what are the dimensions and how to build it. And the dipole, which has much more gain than a monopole, you just add one antenna in the antenna place in the left, and then another one in the ground, which will be the negative part of the dipole. So the antenna should be corresponding to the, should be accordingly made to the wavelength of this 433 megahertz. So I found some instructions in the internet. The total length of, the total length of this antenna is 9 centimeters. The first part is 1.3 centimeters. Then there is a coil which are given number of turns. Let me count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Like 12 or 13 turns, and then there is another straight part. And that's about 5 centimeters. And then to avoid the wire to uncoil, I wrap it with some scotch. And then you just, if you want a monopole, which will already improve a lot the reception, you solder it into this pin, or if you want to even increase further the gain, you can make dipoles. I went with the dipole in the receiver rather than a transceiver because like this we can keep the transmitting power low to be within the rules of your country. So you can always increase gain and performance of your transmitting radio systems without surpassing the rules if you increase the gain of the receiver, not the transceiver. And my idea is to build a weather station in which I will put this in some sensor outside the home, and this will be inside in an Arduino with an LCD attached. Why I don't use the RF22? Because I don't need it. The weather forecast only needs to transmit, it doesn't need to receive the sensor that is outside, so this is enough. It's much cheaper and much simple to to implement. It also needs many less wires because it doesn't use an SPI interface. It's just a kind of amplitude modulated output. So these three pins are ground, voltage, and the output, which is kind of a modulated digital wave. And that's it. I hope it's useful and you try to build the antenna by yourself. Bye.